Hey there, guys. Welcome back to more Tales of Beseria. I've been recording so much Trails of Cold Steel 2, I've literally been saying, welcome to Trails of Cold Steel 2. But welcome to Tales of Beseria. Last episode, we found some interesting things, and then we went on our way. And also, this expedition thing is really cool, because it kept giving me money, equipment, and all that. We found a new place, but we need to level up first. Skill for next voyage. Getsu basic training. And no, we're not going to explore that again. Because right now... Whatever. We're not actually...
Scout ship setting sail.
Now that they're going to be shipping over there, we're going to actually get more experience for expedition. So the expedition pretty much gives you some really good stuff. I would not recommend using it too much unless you like sitting around waiting for it, but it does give you some really good stuff that you might need. So we're going to actually go through here, which is really the only place we can really go for story purposes.
An inspection.
They won't inspect everyone. Just act natural.
Your face is all stiff.
I know.
You, in the black coat. Show me your documentation. Well? Your travel permit from the Abbey? Where is it?
Foolish girl! How many times have I told you? A magician's apprentice must wear a pleasant grin.
Magician?
Verily! I present to you the traveling troupe of mischievous misfits known across the land as... Magilou's Menagerie!
Entertainment for the ceremony?
Why, yes, indeed we are, my dear. Please pardon my uncouth apprentice. Girl, allay the good man's fears and show him the dove trick you've spent all these weeks on. Go to!
Oh, sorry, mistress. I forgot to prepare.
you pathetic little shirker! A proper performer is perpetually prepared!
It's fine. Doves flying around would be a nuisance.
No, this will not do. If you cannot summon a dove, then act like one. Act like a dove!
Coo-coo.
Oh my god. Freaking Velvet's gonna kill you, Magilou. You know that, right?
Remember, Magilou's Menagerie manufactures mirth. That was just a small sample for the good citizenry of Logris.
Hey, you can't advertise here! Move along!
As you say!
That was a fine ploy, Magilou.
Well, don't expect tricks like that every day. Coo coo. Oh, that murderous gaze! Coo coo!
Those doves were amazing!
Just a crude trick. If anything, it just shows the capital's defenses are pathetic.
More like it shows how much confidence they have in those defenses. How many soldiers are here, Lafayette?
The number of exorcists in the capital? At least 1,000. And 2 divisions of guards.
I'd expect no less from the capital. They're not careless. They're covered.
We need transit documents.
See how the citizens smile? To think they were fleeing from demons just a few years ago.
To hold an observance of this scale shows just how much peace their power has brought.
A peace paid for with Luffy's...
Velvet?
Aww. She keeps remembering the fact that this peace was at the cost of her brother's life. Alright, but let's look around and make sure there's no items I'm missing. Got a soul over here and a soul somewhere else. Nutmeg. Happiness at the cost of others' lives. Also, off camera, I did try to grind, but these monsters aren't at the point where I can just farm experience off of them. So that's fun. Also, I actually learned that the expedition actually keeps going even if you're not playing the game. So that's good. So I'm not gonna miss anything. I don't have to keep the game on and play while I'm trying to wait for the expedition to come back. Let's see. No skits. And Magalu's still not in our party, so I can't really try this. Like, when is she gonna join our party, god darn it? It's a lot of guards. Okay. Just trying to get around you guys so I can go to the item shop. Now, on the bright side, this game doesn't have that whole... Oh, malevolence. I mean, it's Demon Blight's kind of the same thing. But at least it's not like, oh no, demons, no. Nah, that crap. Guess we do need some Pensea bottles. Pensea bottles. We got. I think that works. And then some of these. I should have. Tarnished silver coin. Oh yeah, the pirate flag. What are we supposed to do with that? Take this to a shop. That, what the frick? Take this to a shop. Improve the jewel of the moth and claim reward. Wait, was I supposed to use that? Oh no. I probably wasn't supposed to get rid of him like that. At least we now get the damage against stunned foes, so that's a good thing. Nothing here for items. Break soul plus 10. Enhance. Yeah, I think that's enough for that. And more feather, lavender, we all gonna go. Alright, so I guess we go up here and then keep moving. Or are they gonna stop me because it looks like we're close to the stronghold?
Those cheers. The royals sure have these folks in line.
Subjects, may I have your attention? It is I, Percival Asgard, Crown Prince of the Midgard Empire. His Majesty, my father, and I are pleased to celebrate with you on this auspicious day.
The ceremony started.
It'll be impossible to slip in now.
After the opening, 10 years ago, our kingdom faced an existential threat, both from demons and the terrible spread of demon blight. However, one man raised a miraculous sword and stood so that the body and soul of the land
over there
would not be lost.
You can climb up if you want, but attacking now would be suicide.
And the name of that man was Artorias Colbrand!
Artorias! 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 Artorias!
This isn't good.
None here, I trust, are unfamiliar with Artorias' noble act. To bring us salvation from demons, he sacrificed everything.
But he's a murderer.
He called Lord Innominat, one of the five Imperians, and blessed us with the strength of the Malachite.
But he's a murderer! Velvet!
He serves as a shining beacon of reason in this world of turmoil. And reason is what binds us.
But you killed him! You took everything that I loved!
So raise your voices in praise to Artorias' devoted work, to the Savior who purifies evil and guides our flock. Let us call him our Shepherd.
Oh no, this is how the whole Shepherd thing started. Really? This is how the whole Shepherd thing?
Even though the world was filled with suffering, I had to ask something tremendous of you all. I entrusted you to endure the pains of reason. I asked you to bind yourselves with shackles of your own will. For the only blade that can expel calamity is one forged from unshaking reason and the iron will to do what must be done. And now that very blade stands ready before all of us today, I offer my body and my life in service to the people of this great land. With the blessings of the Imperian Innominat, I will guide you to a world without calamity. And this world's suffering will be nothing but a distant memory!
You're the one who murdered.
Fool, they'll see us.
You're the one who killed Lafayette.
What?
The Shepherd Artorias. That's who you're after?
Hoping you just straight up pounce on him.
That would be certain death. No, I need a sword of reason and will. That's the only thing that can kill him.
Killing Lord Artorias. Playing it safe? Boring! Regrettably, it is at this juncture we go our separate ways. I've got a bit of hunting to do.
No one's stopping you.
Goodbye. Farewell! May your days be fruitful and your nights tormented!
If our enemy's calling himself a shepherd, he won't be going into hiding. Let's take this slowly.
The old man behind him. Melchior, I take it?
Yeah.
Let's gather information on these people. If we know what they're planning, we can find a weakness.
They're the most powerful men in the land. If we're going to look into them, we need a lead first.
Aizen, do you have any underworld contacts in the capital itself? Like your friend at the port?
I don't go inland much, I'm afraid. But Ifrid has close ties to a shadow guild. A tavern in the city, run by an old man called Baskerville, serves as a front for them.
A shadow guild? Those sorts of things actually exist?
That settles it. Let's head to that tavern. They'll have food, I'm sure.
Why not?
I kind of feel bad for Lafayette.
My stomach made a weird noise.
That's another sign that you're alive.
It's freaking...
The exorcists sure were out in full force to see the Shepherd's inauguration, weren't they?
What about that guy you're after? Was he there?
What, and have to stand around looking all proper? Nah, that's not his style.
But I thought he was one of the top exorcists.
That wouldn't matter to him.
Huh. Alright.
Actually, Velvet, speaking of the Shepherd, I noticed he wasn't using his right arm. Was he hurt or something?
Yeah. He was badly wounded a long time ago. He lost the use of his sword arm.
That's what I figured.
But don't get the wrong idea. He's still a master swordsman with his left arm.
I can tell that from the way he moves. His movements are steady and measured, and his chi is centered below his navel.
Huh? Why does that matter?
Some people say that all the body's spiritual energy gathers in a place about 2 finger widths below the navel.
Even when he appears to be in a state of total peace, his guard is never down. He's a formidable adversary. And I think I know why my target has placed himself at Artorias's side. Because now I want to take Artorias down too.
Alright, so that was a thing. So, first off, we need to go to this little area right here. I'm thinking this is where we're supposed to go, right? Yep. Okay, why did for a minute there you look like that guy from, like, Yuri on Ice?
What'll it be?
Some food for the boy.
Mabo curry is our specialty. It takes a week to stew properly.
Mabo curry.
Some of that, then. Say, do you know a man named Baskerville? I heard we might find him here.
That old man? A scoundrel and criminal who went against the rules of the Abbey. They executed him long ago.
Oh.
Velvet, this Mabo curry is amazing.
You get along so well. Is he your brother?
No.
No, he wouldn't be, would he? After all, your brother was murdered before your eyes.
Hold up, what?
How do you know that?
The shadows watch those who flinch from the light.
So the guild is still active, even after Baskerville's arrest?
That's right. Just like how Ifrid's crew continues their piracy, even without their captain.
So you're the contact?
What may I help you with?
I want to know what Artorias is planning.
Information such as that? It won't come cheap. I have here a list of jobs, not one remotely legal. Take care of all of them, and I'll tell you what you want to know.
Smooth old lady. Destroy the goods. Search for mission. Foil an ambush. Take on. Search for missing man. Foil an ambush. Let's do foiling an ambush. Found the ambush aimed at the Royal Medical Society at the Manhattan Highway. Let's see. Searching for a missing man. Go find, bring him back to Scholar Medi. Destroy goods. I want you to destroy some goods. Recreate store the warehouse. Let's take on this one. Foiling an ambush. It seems more at my...
Take this with you as documentation. It's fake, but it's a good fake. It'll hold up to inspection.
It's registered to Mogulu's Menagerie?
Oh? Was that not the name you gave to the guard at the gate?
I can see you're a group to be reckoned with.
Report back here once you're finished. However, be aware that should you fail...
Then this conversation never took place. Got it. I'll cause you no trouble.
I appreciate your understanding. You're welcome to stay the night, free of charge. Forget about work until the morning comes.
I like how this works. It's more like you're not just going like goody two shoes. Oh, I can't do something that evil. More like we'll do what we have to do to get what we want.
Right. You're missing Captain Eifried. The captain has done much toward our viability. I promise that I'll share anything I hear about him for no charge.
Thanks. All we know is there was a pendulum on the ground at the last place he was seen. And that Legate Melchior is connected to the captain's disappearance. How? We don't know.
Sounds like you've got problems of your own. Do you really have time to take on ours as well?
I could ask you why you've tied yourself up with Velvet.
Me? I've got a debt to repay. Without her, there's no way I'd have ever found my blade again.
A demon repaying a debt? Ridiculous.
As ridiculous as a pirate Moloch, you think? No matter how you look at it, there's nothing reasonable about our rogue existence. And in this brave new world governed by reason, a rogue can either rage and become a monster like me, or...
Or band together with others. Like a ship full of pirates, perhaps.
Exactly. I admire Velvet's courage, squaring off against the whole world on her own. Few can accomplish that. It takes strength. Real strength. And I'm curious where it comes from.
So you're doing it for yourself after all?
Is that so wrong?
No. I'm the same. I need allies on my side, with the strength and courage to combat this so-called order imposed by the Abbey. But anyone who's willing to put up with the creed folly of Eifried's pirates has to be an even bigger fool than we are. So I'm like you. I want to know how deep her foolishness goes.
She'd kill you if she heard that, you know.
It's a compliment. Fools that big aren't born every day.
Uh-huh. And I imagine your dear Captain Eifried's much the same.
Aye. That man flies his fool flag proudly.
The Shepherd Artorius, hmm? He's got the populace eating from the palm of his hand. I wonder... Just how deeply will the fangs of our would-be tragic heroine scar this broken world of ours? I've got a traitor to find, but in the meantime, this should be a good show.
I wonder if she's actually going to join our party or not. Also, I do love how the characters interact with each other in this game. It's a lot more travel permit, got a new recipe, Mabo Curry. That's it! I've come up with a new recipe!
A kind face for such a hard woman.
She knew about me and our cover. She's got ears everywhere.
And that's not all. She called the papers fake, but they're not.
So she's got spies working on the inside, too.
I heard that her predecessor, Baskerville, was a monument against authority. But to think he was executed.
They've lost their leader, but remain unconquered. Not an organization to trifle with.
That's how they have to be to take on the Abbey. We'd better succeed on our missions, and not just to get the information we need.
Yeah. Besides, I'd like to get another of those drinks, too.
You're a man of taste. That place always has the best.
You'd better work hard, too, if you want more Mabo Curry.
I will.
Good kid. Well, at least now we got Mabo Curry, so I can always make that. Oh, no. Dealing with customers here is harder than any job the Bloodwings could throw at you. Care to see for yourself? Serving game rules, item exchange. It's the same stuff from earlier, it looks like. So just, let's see, this game is where you're trying to bring the right orders to customers. Oh yeah, this is what I remember. I looked around and apparently there was this dining mini game that reminded me of Diner Dash when I was a kid. I used to play that a crap ton on my phone and on my old computer. Like, Diner Dash was like my favorite game. Okay, let's see. Customers who will be waiting for their orders will be taken with speech balloons over their heads. Start by taking their orders, next head over to the counter, and then collect the proper orders from the cooks. Lastly, try to take the right orders to the right customers. Each time you do so, it counts as a successful order. If you bring a customer the wrong order or make them wait too long, they'll get angry and it will count as a failed order. Each completed order, whether success or failure, will count towards the required amount of orders to complete each stage. But you'll need to be careful. You're only allowed a limited number of failed orders before getting a game over. Each game is being played in a series of three stages. When you finish a stage, you can choose whether to continue the next stage or quit the game. If you quit the game, you'll be rewarded with Tales coins based on the number of stages you've cleared. If you continue to play, you can go on to the next stage, where you'll get more customers and greater numbers of orders to fill. However, the requests will be greater. The key to this is carefully watching the customers' orders while working efficiently to deliver their orders before they get angry. You can carry multiple dishes at one time, so try to plan your route to be efficient as possible. If you're short on time, you can always get a bit. It can sometimes be better to carry a lighter load. Let me save the game first in case it's like an actual, like, you fail the game type thing. Let's try. No. We can only do it with Loppy set? No. Pudding. Okay. Mild curry. Yep. Good thing he can run fast. Continue. Mild curry. Come on, dude. Fruitcake. Rossetto. This isn't that hard. Fruitcake. God, dude, you already had a fruitcake. There we go. What are you, Neptune now? Like, what's up with you and pudding, dude? Let's see. Homemade bread. Savory. Come on. What do you want? Rosetto. This dude wants either fruitcake or pudding every time. You're so earnest and honest, it hurts. Keep this up, and I think you'll find yourself in your very own fan club. Put this uniform on and take it. Ah, no. Here's a nice bow tie with your uniform. Remember, looking professional is half the job. Your expedition has returned. What'd they give me?
Take a...
Okay, twin shark and three lemons.
This recipe looks real tasty.
That's it! I've come up with a new recipe! Yeah, we're gonna
Scout ships.
Go on another voyage. Yeah, let's actually see what that bow tie did for us. So, can I... Well, I think it's... Yep, serpent's bow tie. It's high noon. Oh my god. Actually, I think that kind of fits Velvet a little bit. Totally not because I have a thing for Neko's. Okay, we got hats, anchor glasses, Devour bottles. We need a few more before I get Mini Luger. Ludger. I keep saying the wrong name sometimes, so forgive me for that. Velvet, let's try. We gotta do this with Velvet. Fruitcake, banana pie, one guy, fruitcake, okay, tofu salad, that's the first thing I'm looking at, mild curry. Banana pie. Pudding. Here, Neptune, you can have some frickin' pudding. There we go. So with each character, there's just more and more more customers. Salad. Tofu salad. Mabo curry. Tofu salad. Mabo curry. Peach pie. I'm good at memorizing things, not so good when it comes to helping people. Seafood salad. What the? Oh my god, no. No. Oh no. Oh no. Mild curry. Dude, you ordered. Oh my god. Peach pie. My god, why? Okay, peach pie. What? Wait, okay, so. Okay. Let me see, can I get the mini... No, I cannot get the mini Luger yet. Oh, let's try this again. Okay. Fruitcake. Peach pie. Fruitcake. Peach pie. Boom. Boom. Tofu salad. Mabo curry. Peach pie. Pudding. There we go. Clear out the first stage very quickly. Now for the second. Okay, you want consomme, whatever the hell that is. Here it is. You want seafood salad, you want mabo curry. Seafood salad, mabo curry. Boom. Boom. Peach pie. You want seafood salad. You want fruitcake. Seafood salad. Fruitcake. Seafood salad. What do you want? Oh, I didn't read what she wanted. No. Peach pie. Okay. She wants peach pie. He wanted mabo curry. It's a good thing they remind you what they actually want, just so you don't accidentally mess up, because that can get really bad really quick. Ooh. All right, let's see. Pudding. And sadly, even if you're the counter, they don't really help. Seafood salad. Mild curry. Seafood cake. Mild curry. Seafood salad. Boom. Boom. What? What did you want, old man? Peach pie. Delete all. Okay. Peach pie. Mild curry. Seafood salad. Consume. Mild curry. Seafood salad. Consume. Oh my god, why? There, we're done. We got a whole bunch of Tails coins, which is good. You made everyone feel like they were right at home. Thanks for your help. Keep that uniform of yours for your efforts. Now look. Oh my god. you got me messed up, woman. You realize how annoying that was? Yes, we had to get Mini Luger. We had to. Service time, Mini Luger. Ah, that's cute! I don't give a fur. He's like, yeah! Like, yeah! I had to screenshot that real quick. I had to take a photo of that. That's so freaking cute. Oh my god, it moves with you! Oh my god, that's adorable. Oh my god. He's like, yeah. Can we get any items here, actually? Let's see. Doesn't look like... Oh my god, that's still so freaking cute, dude. Sake. That's so cute. Actually, we need to see what that mabo curry does, skill-wise. We got mabo curry and twin shark manier. Restores 1 BG, trigger... Prevents status ailments. Wait, prevents all status ailments? Yeah, let's do it. We're gonna have Aizen cook it.
Good choice. Prepare for the Reaper's Feast.
Just to level up his cooking skill, but that's so cool that the accessory actually moves with you.
So, somebody means to ambush the Royal Medical Society on the Danann Highway.
The Royal Medical Society is a group of doctors that travel around healing the sick.
They're funded by donations given by ordinary folk.
Why would anyone attack them?
Don't ask me. Some people are just twisted.
And why would an underworld group defend them?
Who knows? Something to do with the attackers, perhaps?
Ooh, That's so cute. It's like, yeah, what? That's weird. Do we not have the ingredients for it? Oh, that's why.
You sure you want me for this?
That's so cute. Alright, so, Ant Foil Ambush. That's where. Where are we going exactly? That's so freaking cute, so this is like freaking worth it, dude. For me, it's worth it. I don't know about other people, but that's. I had to get that.
Greetings, Magilu's Menagerie. You've come to exactly the right place.
You must be a Bloodwing. What do you want?
You already know about the Code Red demons, right?
The really strong demons the Abbey wants gone? Yeah.
Would you ever consider hunting them down for us? We'll reward you properly.
Reward? Why pay us when the Abbey would do it for free?
It's complicated. The Abbey is calculating in their deployments, especially where Code Red demons are concerned.
I get it. They'll only act if they determine the demon would cause more harm than the losses they'd incur in battling it. That does seem logical.
But sometimes, people have lost a loved one to such a demon. Or sometimes, they have a connection to the person the demon used to be. Wherever there's a Code Red demon, you can bet there are people willing to pay good money to have it killed.
And let me guess, that's where the Bloodwings come in.
Exactly. There are Bloodwings all throughout Midgant who have information on these Code Red demons. If you defeat a demon and report back to my comrades, they'll make sure you're well compensated.
All right, I understand. But I won't make any promises.
That's fine. No sense in drawing up a contract when the hunter probably won't survive anyway. If you get results, let us know. We'll hold up our end. That being said, I'd feel guilty if I didn't help out at least a little, so here, take this.
Hmm?
Those Bloodwings are definitely a rough crowd.
To be fair, things are never that straightforward when you're dealing with demons.
All that matters is that there's something in it for us if we hunt those Code Red demons. The only thing better than fighting formidable foes is getting paid for it.
Just remember that these Code Red demons are tough enough to make the Abbey shiver. We'd be wise not to underestimate them.
We should talk to those Bloodwings before considering any of the marks. They might have information that will help us prepare.
Yeah. And we better remember to upgrade our equipment.
Right.
Hmm. Enough bottles. Hmm. You can use enough bottles to teleport you down a village. Enough bottles to teleport you directly to specific locations.
Hey, Lafayette.
What is it, Rokuro?
Mabo curry.
Huh?
Ooh. You're an interesting one. You like Mabo curry that much, huh?
It smells good. And it's creamy and kind of spicy. Eating it made me feel nice.
I'd say you love it then. Do all Malakim have such an appetite?
Each has their own tastes. Some eat a lot, some eat a little. Just like humans or demons.
What do you like, Aizen?
Drinks, I suppose.
What else?
Pretty much just drinks.
Don't you like anything else?
Is it a problem if I don't?
No. I'm just wondering.
For me, it's drinks and candied sweet potatoes.
That's where you boil strips of sweet potato in oil and then coat them in sugar, right?
Yeah, I never get tired of them.
So you like to drink, but you've also got a sweet tooth?
Yeah. Is that so strange?
No.
Candied sweet potatoes. Sounds good.
There's nothing to be ashamed of. It's just a sign that you're alive, remember?
Right.
So, wait, no, this isn't the place where we utterly burn the place down to the ground, it doesn't look like. They still got 11 minutes before they can come back.
All right, the guards are gone. Let's move in.
Benwick and the crew did a fine job.
Grab some of this.
Red crates. These must be our targets. The seal of Midgant Cathedral?
Should we look inside?
There's no need. Burn them, Lafayette.
Okay.
We're done here. Let's go.
That storm cost too much time. I must report to Lord Artorias as soon as possible. It's you!
Oh, hey. The crybaby.
Hume, Exorcist Praetor.
Oh, cool. Actually, what level is Eleanor? Level 15. She's stronger than we are.
You won't get away this time.
You really want to fight, don't you?
Wow, I can aim. Yeah, I could really not aim during all that. So, do we just make it a habit to beat up every person who joins our party? Let's get rid of these guys since they seem to be a major problem. There is no way that is a freaking female. Like, look, the build on these people are ridiculous. Yeah, there is no way we're supposed to. I mean, we probably can beat her, but we're probably not supposed to.
No escape! Make a sign! Hold up! Make a sign! See this? Put down the pain and move! Make a sign! Hold up! Make a sign! Hold up! Hold up!
Hold up! Hold up! Hold up! Hold up! Hold up! Okay, yeah, forgetting that move's kind of a problem. If used properly.
Yeah.
done.
Willing to fight without your Malakine?
No! You set the storehouse ablaze? The people have worked so hard to withstand this time of crisis. How can you destroy what they have so painstakingly built?
Because I'm not human.
You'll pay for this, you demon!
More Malakim up her sleeves?
I will protect you, Madam Eleanor!
Oh no, it's freaking, Normans. Oh, why?
Come and face me now, demon! He's adorable. Am I?
Dude, keep it in your pants, that's a guy.
Ooh, I found you at last! That bad, bad voice! Bien Fu, you traitor! You'll never leave my clutches again! Not her! No! What are you doing? Get out there and fight!
Hey, look! Is that smoke? It is! Fire!
The fire has spread enough. Let's get going.
You're coming with us.
Let me go! Witchnappers!
Madam Exorcist! What happened? Oh, you're badly hurt.
I can wait. Gather the people and put out that fire.
Yes, madam.
Tell me, do you know what was being kept in that warehouse?
Mostly nectar, I believe. Vast stores of the medicine, provided by High Priest Gideon, to be distributed to doctors across the land.
Medicine given by the church? Why would anybody destroy it?
And we're gone. Dang, everybody leveled up except for Aizen. Geostigma, Shell Splitter. Intermediate isotope. Unlocks level 2 random skills. Hit points, crossing burns, potential respiratory attack. Phantasm lasts around 6 to 30 seconds and extremely dangerous if ignored. You can count.
Whew. Looks like we're in the clear.
Misfortune and anguish! I had that little turncoat right in front of me! Well, at least now I know where to find him!
That weird little Moloch was the one you were looking for?
The very same! The Moloch Bien Fu! A creature of unfathomable wickedness and beguiling cuteness who broke the heart of this wretched maiden! Once I finally catch him, who knows what I'll be capable of?
Not sure I get it.
Me neither.
Good. Pray that you never do.
Trouble at the docks, was there? Well, so long as the job was done. Good luck. I look forward to hearing your report.
A scholar missing on the road to Gallus Lake.
Strange request.
If they know where he vanished, why don't they just look for him there?
Exactly. And what's so illegal about a missing persons case that you gotta go to the underworld?
I can think of a few possibilities, but our job isn't to ask questions.